This video tutorial shows you how to pay maintenance fees using MySIPO patents. From the MySIPO patents homepage, in the Pay Maintenance Fees tile, click on Pay Maintenance Fees. We can see that there are two tabs, by number and by file upload. The first one will allow you to pay maintenance fees by providing application and patent numbers directly on screen, whereas the second one will allow you to pay maintenance fees by uploading an XML file. Let's start with the By Number tab. Enter one or multiple application and/or patent numbers. If entering multiple numbers, these must be separated by a comma, space, or line break. Click Next. The system will conduct a validation against the formatting of the entered numbers. It will also verify whether the numbers exist in our back-end system. The results of this verification will be displayed in the validation results table. Note that only entries with a passed or warning result will be carried forward to the next step. To view the details of an entry, to edit it or delete it from the table, click on the corresponding button under Actions. Hovering your mouse over the buttons will allow you to see which action corresponds to which button. To add another application or patent number, click on Add Another. Enter the number and click Add and Validate. Once all the application and patent numbers have been added, click Start Submission. For each application or patent in the table, hover your mouse over the field under Number of Maintenance Fees Being Paid, click on the edit icon represented by a pencil, and enter the number of maintenance fees being paid. Click on Save. The other fields of the table will then auto-populate with the appropriate anniversary years covered by the submission and any applicable late fee. To open a pop-up box containing the details for the particular application or patent, click on the corresponding button under Actions. Maintenance fees are applied to each application or patent based on whether our back-end system recognizes a valid small entity declaration or not. To override this auto recognition, you may elect to pay small entity fee or standard fees. The checkbox to override this auto recognition is displayed at the midpoint on the pop-up. Check the box if applicable and click on Save. The fees will be adjusted accordingly. Click Close. To delete an entry from the table, click on the button under Actions represented by a trash can. If you are ready to submit the request, click Review and Submit in the top right-hand corner of the page. Review the information displayed. At the bottom of the page, click Submit and Pay to continue. Otherwise, click Back if you do not wish to submit or would like to make changes to your request. Let's return to the initial screen to see how to pay maintenance fees by uploading an XML file. Click on the tab By File Upload. Note that the XML schema has been changed from what is currently being used. Click on the Maintenance Fee XML Schema link to view the schema template that is required to be used for this option. To download the template, click on the Download button. Click on the X to close the pop-up. To select a file for upload, either click Upload Files or drag and drop the file in the designated area. Click Next. This initiates a preliminary validation of the XML file to confirm that the file uploaded correctly, that it matches the expected schema, that it conforms to the maximum allowed patent or application numbers, and that it identifies a valid number of years to maintain for each patent or application. A failure on any one of these elements will require you to try again. If the upload is successful, you will be brought to the same validation results table as was seen through the By Number process. After clicking on Start Submission, the steps will be similar to those of the By Number process, except that values in the Maintenance Fee Payments table will be auto-populated based on the XML for each entry. Stay tuned for more video tutorials to continue learning about the various functionalities of MySIPO patents.